morning, everybody. It's about 6 in the morning. It's minus 34 here in Yellowknife. I've made some coffee before I go out and have a coffee and sit on the computer for 45 minutes before I go off onto the elliptical machine, which is my usual routine. I just thought I'd say, let's look at a game. We are going on vacation. My wife and I are headed off to Greece. We are taking a back-to-back cruise in the Mediterranean, and one of our stops is for 2 days in Istanbul. Now, as we know, Istanbul comes in two flavors. We come in a resource management Euro-style game where you visit the market with your workers. I went the different route only because I wanted a smaller footprint game to possibly take with us on our cruise, and therefore I have Istanbul, the dice game. So let's go down to the table, take a quick look at the box opening. Now, I know this game's a few years old, but it's relevant to me because I am going on vacation, and the footprint on this game isn't that big that you could pack it and take it away with you. It's also a dice game, and I love dice placement. So without any further ado, let's go down to the table, take a quick look at the unboxing of Istanbul, the dice game. There it is on the table. It's in the box. It's new in shrink. This is by Rutger Dorn. And it is by AEG, the dice game. And it is 14 and up, 30 minutes to play, and for four players. Sorry, I have cataracts. The light just, and I can't get them fixed yet. The doctor goes, your eyesight's still good. Can you still read? Yes, then you're okay. Well, I guess medical for you. Okay. So here is the, we are welcome to the Bazaar of Istanbul, and we are going to play this game. It's a standalone dice game set in the world of Istanbul, winner of the Kinespiel de Jara 2014. So this is an award-winning game, obviously, or at least the bigger version is. And I am very excited to try this. It says, welcome to the Bazaar of Istanbul. Are you ready for a trade competition? If so, you will need to acquire the coveted rubies faster than your competitors. You are not alone. Your assistants will collect goods and money for you. Use your income wisely to invest in improved abilities or to save you for purchasing rubies. With a little bit of luck and the right strategy, you will be victorious and become the master of the trade guild. Okay, let's get this game open and take a look at what's inside. Okay, let's see if we can. I even gave myself a little start here and I still can't open the damn thing. Oh my God. This is what happens when you have to do things at 6 in the morning. The house is quiet, the dogs are fed, the wife's in bed, and we have to go to work in a little while. Okay, let's just get rid of this crinklies in my pocket, get them the knife. Let's go open the box. The rules on top, that's pretty standard. We have all of them. So here's the player board, you can see it right there. That is exactly what I'm looking for in a game, really. This is a small footprint. It's too bad there's no solo version, but that doesn't mean there isn't one. Here are various tokens. You can see dice rolls, so I'm assuming that you can... It's a dice placement game of some sort, so I suppose that you can buy these things and do something with it. There's our, looks like our goods. We have some money and more goods. We got some dice and all kinds of exciting things, and this must be player boards of some sort. So I'm not sure all how it all goes together, but it looks like a very small footprint game, which is exciting to me. So we're going to organize this, bring it back, and then we're going to play a few rounds of it, and we are going to play Istanbul, the dice game by AEG. So let's head out. But first, I'm going to get ready for work. So this is going to be a later on adventure. So we've got a couple of games that I'm working on. And it's very exciting because when I come back, we're working on a games cafe. Here in Yellowknife, I have a business partner. And we hope to be open by the end of June or July. Very, very exciting. I will be managing and be a working partner of this endeavor. This is my retirement. So I'm very excited to move from my wage slave job here at the government of the Northwest Territory to ownership of a cafe. I was a chef. I was a chef till about 1999. I went to school and took computer science from 1995 to 1999. Got my degree, went into IT, and I've been in IT ever since. In 2012 through about 2015, I got my master's degree. I'm a certified project manager, certified change manager. I'm a business analyst, systems analyst. I've had all those, and I've been a developer. But now I'm going back into the restaurant business and the cafe. And if you ever get the Yellowknife, once we open up, I do hope you join us. I can't tell you what the name is. I can only tell you that it's happening. But let's go down and get this organized. Here we are. We have set it up and organized it. Well, we've organized it. The setup will come next, I promise. Over here are the rules again. Here is the ruby board. And we will be putting rubies on all of these boards and then doing certain activities will give us rubies. The idea of this game is to be the first player to use 6 rubies. And we will manipulate the dice roll. So this is kind of a roll and write almost. Kind of an interesting roll and write perhaps. Or very reminiscent of an early roll and write. We have our cards and we'll use these cards. You'll be able to purchase these cards through some actions. In this case, this will allow us to trade a mosque tile for another mosque tile and still get a crystal or 1 lira. You can see I've organized. These are the goods. And basically what we're going to be doing is you're going to manipulating dice. And you can see that down here. Oh. And through the roll of dice, we're going to be taking some of these. Now, these represent the dice. The reason why, of course, that you're going to want to do that is because sometimes you're going to need 5 or 6 of the same dice to get something. And, of course, you can't only use the dice that you have in front. So if you're only rolling 5 dice and you need to get 6 rings or 6 metal, you're going to have to use some of these. So you're going to be trading. So there's lots of dice trading in here. These are your mosque tiles. You can see this one is an income tile because it has the 3. You have to buy this for 3 of the same color dice or some of the resource tiles. Here are your dice. There are 9 dice. There are your rubies. These are your crystals. Crystals allow for rerolls, 1 or more, if you want, or all, or it's just some. And there are your lira. And of course, everything just goes back in the box very, very nicely. Big box, little game. Could have almost had a little fold out here, and you could have gotten this game almost down to a tiny epic size. But anyway, that is what is sitting in Istanbul, the dice game. And before I forget, I should mention that these were mini euros. And of course, that is this size here. I only had a bag because I had a lot of loose ones in there. And that is 44 by 69 millimeters. And this is what fit the Istanbul cards. I did try the other 2 cards, the 41 by 63, but it did not work. So I had to go up to the mini euros. That is it for Istanbul. And we are now going to go down to the table and set this up and play. So we are ready to play. This is Istanbul, the dice game. I have tried to compact this as much as I can, so it might look slightly different on your table than it does on my table. Starting up here, we have the mosque tiles, and each one of these tiles will help us in some way each of our turn as we buy them. The cost is at the top, so if we bring this up, this one says basically that I'm going to get 3 lira per turn, and to buy this, I'm going to have to spend 3 of the food or fruit resources, and that is the yellow. And I can do that in any combination of the dice and these resources. These are just resources that we're going to buy because we're never going to have enough dice to actually spend 6 dice, maybe. So we were going to depend on buying some of these and trading some of our dice based on this reference card here. And these are the actions that we're going to take. And we're going to go over these actions as we play. Here we have our knight and our orc. They are ready to play. And they have their reference cards here, as I do, so that I can help them play as well. We have our cards. And the cards, I'll just randomly help us. So if we can buy a card, let's just say we roll a card and we want to take a card or more, we would flip over the first dice. And in this case, we have one person has the choice of trading in two of these crates for 6 lira or just taking a lira. Now, crates are not on the dice, they are wild. And here we are. There are group ones too. So let's just say I drew this card, I could get a fruit and 3 lira. The rest of the folks who are playing can pick up either 3 lira or a fruit. And that's how that plays. We'll just give that a quick shuffle. Over here are the rest of the mosque tiles. I just didn't have room over here. We have our dice. We will roll 5 dice to start. There are mosque tiles that allow us to add extra dice. Our rubies are set up. We are going to be buying from this market here. The first rubies on each one of these tracks are 4, so we need 4 fabric, 4 jewelry, 4 fruit, and 4 spices. Here is a bit of a difference. Now, in a 3-player game, these would be covered. So what we're going to need to do is we're going to have 12 lira to buy this first crystal, and it keeps increasing, 14, 16, all the way up. Over here, I would have to have 4 different resources, whether it's a combination of dice and the resources up here, and plus one more. And as we take this off, this would be +2, and on, 3 and 4. So as you can see, things get more expensive as we get along. Here is a one-time bonus when you get up to 5 of the mosque tiles. You can take one of these. This is a race game. This is a rolling the dice, as I explained earlier. It's almost a roll and write. Now, this is not a new game. This is new to my collection only because we are actually going to Istanbul. And I wanted to take a game on the cruise that sort of was representative of the game of the places that we're going. And one of the games that I will be buying is Santorini, and we'll be taking Santorini with us as well. So with that being said, let's go through the game, and we're going to play. As I said, it is the knight versus the orc. So let's get down to the board and start playing. Well, finally made it to the table here. You can see I haven't put my picture down here just to save a little space out here on the board. This board doesn't take up a lot of space, but I just wanted to get lower down so that you can see all the goodness that's going on here. And we're all set up, as we explained. We have our dice right over here, just a little bit off camera. We're going to start with 5, of course. The knight is going to start first. Both players get a crystal, and crystal allows you to do rerolls. And of course, we have our coin. And because if you were playing a 3-4 player, the next player would get 2 coin, and the player after that would get 3 coin. And of course, the first player gets no coin. That's a typical Euro, even though there's a high random factor here. Here are the different actions, and we're going to be playing through these different actions. So when we roll our dice, if we get 2 of a kind, of course, we could take any resource. If we roll a or B, in other words, 2 different, of course, we could pick up a crystal. A, B, C, three different dice rolls, we can pick up a wild. If we roll an A, B, C, D, 4 of a kind, we can get 2 resources. If we get the money symbol, we will get 2 per each. Cards, we can pick up a card. We get 4 question marks. We can certainly buy a mosque tile. So you've got to have not only the 4 of a kind, but you've got to buy the mosque tile. So you have to have 4 dice to buy a mosque tile, and then 3 dice, 3 gems, depending on where they are, 3 or more gems, basically, to buy a ruby. And here it tells you that these are equal to dice and that a crate is equal to anything. So just to clarify, to get a mosque tile, you actually use the symbols on the top of the mosque tile here. Let's just bring those down. Somehow it got, I did something and it's kind of readjusted the angle on me, which is not too bad, but everything's still good. You can just see the cards up here, which is good. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is our knight. We're going to roll 5 dice. We'll just put these off to the side if we don't need them. We have our handy dice thing here. So we have a card, and then we can take 2 actions depending on what we have here. So we have 2 of those. We have 2 different if we want, and we have a card. Now, I could use a crystal to re-roll these 3 if I want, or any combination of these 2, or I can get another crystal, or I could get 1, 2, whoops, this is a card. I could use 3 different to get a crate, which is wild, and then still take a card. Okay, so let's do that. So we're going to take a wild. And then we're going to take a single card. Now, I don't know whether it's going to be good for us or not. We may not even be able to use it. So this will allow us to take any single resource into any 2 resources. Or we could take a lira. So having a wooden crate is wild. So I could actually trade this for any 2 resources. So let's go with 2 green, and we're going to look for 4 here. So we're going to take these 2 green, and we will discard our card. And that is the end of our turn. It's as simple as that. We took 2 actions. We are now over to our knight. Just get rid of that shadow. Whoops. We rolled 4 of the 5 dice. And we have a blue. So I think what he's going to do is he's going to take a yellow resource. He's got 2 yellows. And he's going to take liras. 1, 2. Just like that. And that is his 2 actions. And you can see how fast this game plays. We'll come back over here, roll our 5 dice. Oh, we have 3 yellows. So 3 AAA. Let's just take a look and see what we can do here. 3 of a kind will let us come over to here, and we can buy an extra action, 3 lira, or every time we got 2. Wow. So extra, unless I get an extra dice, an extra action. Oh my gosh, these are good too. But I think what we're going to do is just come over here, and we're going to take this 3 lira. And that means at the beginning of the turn, we will produce 3 lira. That takes care of them. And then we have an A and a B. We'll just take another crystal, and that'll allow us to re-roll. We come over here to our orc. So he has an A, B, C. So he's going to pick up a crate. And of course, we replace a mosque tile with another crystal. And he's going to take a card as well. So here's an interesting card. This allows me to pick up 4 lira, and I can spend a crystal for 3 lira. So he's going to pick up 4 lira, so that's going to give him 5. And I think we have the extra crystal, so he might as well pick up 3 lira as well. Pardon my dogs. They have a food cube out there, and they're fighting over it. Now I'm going to come back to our knight. So the first thing he's going to do is pick up 3 lira. And he's going to roll his dice. So these are very helpful. This helps speed the game up, which is keeps this game moving along fairly quickly. Okay, we have 3 cards and 2 green. Well, he gets to pick up a green resource, which is always nice. And he's going to pick up 3 cards, but he can only choose 1. So he's going to pick up 3 cards. 1, 2, and 3. Let's turn this around. So he can spend, he can get another 4 lira. Or he can get a pineapple on 3 lira. But he has a pineapple already. Or he can turn, so this means that if I have a crate, which I do, I could take a crate. I like this one. Is take a lira, take a pineapple or food, I should say, and 3 more lira. So I'll take another 2. So that gives me 10 lira. Over here, I can take a 3 lira or a pineapple. I don't really need a pineapple. So I think he's going to take 3 more lira. We'll see how that plays out. 1, 2, and 3. And of course, we're going to discard those cards. It is now our knight's turn. Oh, there he goes. He's got a pineapple. Wow. Okay, so he is going to take a... Looks like he's going to take a 3 of a kind, which allows him to come back up here. So he's going to do this. He's going to spend the 3 to pick up another mosque tile. Wow, very lucky. Oh, and of course he gets his 3 lira from the beginning. So actually at this point he has 12. 1, 2, and 3. That's nice. So he's got 12 lira now. So for his second move is he's going to spend all 12. To pick up a... ruby, the first ruby. Now we're going to come over to here. We're going to roll. Oops, we have an extra crate here for some reason. Now we're going to come over here and roll. So we have 2. We have a pineapple. 2 greens. So he's going to actually take his 2 greens to take another green. Take his... For his second move, he's going to spend 3 plus the dice here for the pineapple. And he's going to take a card. So he can get a card every turn. And that is as easy as this turn gets. We're going to come back over here. Of course, we have our first blood ruby here. First thing he's going to get to do is get 3 lira. And we're going to turn this one over. Oh, there we are. Another crystal. Wow, there's like crystals everywhere. Anyway, that's rolled. We have 2 yellows. So we're going to take our first action, the 2 A actions, and we're going to take a fruit. Then we're going to get 2 lira. Now, when I take a 2 lira action, I can get another pineapple. Or fruit, I like it. Fruit. The reason why I'm saying pineapple, of course, is because there's pineapple. That is the 2 turns. Wow, these turns just snap by. Of course, he gets a card first, though. Production. Now, if he has 2 crate, he could take 2 crystal. He doesn't, so he would just get 1 lira. He's going to come over to here. He has 2 greens, and his next action, he's actually going to spend 4 greens, because he has his crate here, and he can now pick up his first ruby, and that is his 2 actions. We come back over here, we get 3 more lira, 1, 2, 3, he gets to roll the dice. Well, not really much here. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4 of a kind, which actually isn't too bad, and a card. So if we took our 4 of a kind, and you can see we have the green, the red, and blue, and we can look here, green, red, blue, and one other, he'll get rid of a pineapple. He can pick up a ruby. His second action, he can pick up a single card. Well, maybe it'll work for him. he can pick up a crate. Everybody else gets a pineapple or fruit. So he can pick up a crate. He picks up a pineapple. That's pretty good. Pretty good. He's got two rubies to one. If you hear a little rattling, what you're hearing is a dog in a food cube. If you've never seen a food cube, it's a rounded square where you put food in it and they bat it around. So we've won. And he gets a card at the beginning of his turn. You get four lire, or if he had a blue, he could turn in a blue for four. Everybody else can turn in a blue, so this doesn't do any good for him. He picks up four lira, which is great, actually. So for his first action, he is going to turn in 14 lira to pick up his second cube. And he has a pineapple. He's got two of a kind. He doesn't really have anything else. He has an AB. He could get a crystal. I think he'll pick up 4 lira for his second action. And that's, of course, from these two dice. We're back over to here. We're only going to play through 3 rubies here. I think this is giving you enough of the flavor of the game to understand how it's played. We're going to come over here. This is excellent, actually. Of course, he does get to pick up his three lira. That takes him to 11 lira. At this case, he would need 14 to get to the next one. That's not bad. That would give him 14 plus a pineapple. So the first thing he's going to do is pick up 4 lira. He will get a fruit because he does that, and then he can spend 14 to pick up the next ruby, and as you can see, that becomes 16. That is as simple as this game is. I played a two-player game, of course, our knight versus our orc, but it was a lot of fun. Let's go up. Let's have some final thoughts. Hi, everybody. Here I am. It is about 6 o'clock in the morning, and this is the usual time I do my taping. If you heard some rattling in the background, as I said before, that probably was one of the dogs playing with the food cube. It's probably Athena the puppy. She is a sponsor of my videos at this point. She is our 76th foster from the NWTSPCA, and she is a great dog, and I so much want to keep her. Unfortunately, because of what's going on in my life, and I'm going to put up a vlog later on today, we'll talk about some of the things that are going on in my life, game-wise and life-wise, but I'm going to try a new format vlog, but that's not what we're here to talk about now. What we're here to talk about is, of course, what's laying before us, which is Istanbul, the dice game. This is a synthesis of Istanbul, very, very simple. This is a typical 5-5-5 game in my mind. And when I talk about that, the triple five, I'm talking about 5 minutes to set up, 5 minutes to learn, and 5 minutes to tear down. These are the perfect games for putting on a table. This is very much a filler game. I don't know if it's a gateway. It's about resource management, so it's a filler gateway style. It's very, very lightweight. Very inexpensive. I think this copy was around 40 bucks. The components are fine. Typical of what you would find, the very nice crystals for the rubies and the crystals. Cardboard money. Now, I did drop one somewhere and it rolled under the desk and it's going to sit there forever until I can get down on my hands and knees and pick that up. We have cardboard tokens. It'd be kind of nice if they were geeked up a little bit. I'm using the geek board. Board Game Geek's reference to geeking up a part, but I mean, you could probably find food, crates, fabric, and metal or rings or jewelry out there if you'd look for it hard enough. But you can see how fast this game gets. It takes a little while to get the engine going. Once the engine gets going, you know, you get some real advantages of having your Moss cards. You know, the money starts to come in, and it doesn't become much of a blocker, you know, as the prices go up. As you can see over here, 5, 6, and that final one is a 6. This last one here would be 20. But, you know, once you get enough of these types of cards and you're making money and you're getting constant resources all the time at the beginning of every turn, so there's some real mechanisms to ramp up a little bit of an engine here so that this game doesn't feel overly long. And you can see I played 3 turns, and you can see how quickly we got to 3 rubies. So if you're playing a 2-player game, this probably is less than 30 minutes, probably 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Even if you add 3 and 4, if they're kind of on the ball, you could probably do it in an hour or less. There's no take back. There's no real take that in this game, except that you might take a resource or something that they have, and then, of course, that forces the price up. So component-wise, it's good. Rules are very simple. The aesthetics, I can't complain. I mean, it's a small frame on the table here. I like those kinds of games, those small footprint games. In fact, you know, I'm moving my collection that way. So I'm going to give this basically 2 thumbs up, because I think that if you're looking for a filler, I think this is a game you could play, and I think you could teach kids. I don't know. I'll have to take a look at what they're saying for 14 and up. I'm saying, you know what? So they're saying 14 and up for this game. I say 10. I think you could teach a keen 10-year-old if they have the patience to do this. There's really not a lot. I think they would enjoy the buying and selling of the game. So I think they've just thought that this game would be a little appealer to adults. But I think you could teach it to a 10-year-old, maybe your 11-year-old, depending on that. Even younger, I've been able to teach Lockout to 8 and 9-year-olds, and they just absolutely adore that game. I think it's because of the graphics, and you're in jail and you've got your goblin group. So games can be taught for kids that are have an interest in them. If they don't have an interest in a game, it's not going to happen for you. Anyway, if you like what you see, please subscribe, hit the like button, hit the notifications if you want some notifications of this types of games. As always, I'm here, and I appreciate you when you visit and watch my videos. My community is small, and I've never really qualmed. I never started this because I was looking to build thousands of followers. So I hope you like what you see. If you do, put it down in the comments, or if you want to say hi, find me somewhere on Board Game Revolution or Board Games for One, Everything Board Games, Solo Board Game Group, Sue Board Gamers, the Board Game Group, and probably a dozen other specific games like Role Play Adventure and those types of things. That's it for now. I'm going to go have a coffee. I've got to get ready for work. It's very, very busy. So I will talk to you all later. Bye-bye for now. That's nobody's business but the Turks.